Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, everyone. Welcome to episode 10, Moments with the Quran. Today we take an ayah from Surah An-Nisa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu la ta'kulu amwalakum baynakum bilbatil illa an takuna tijaratan an taradhim minkum wa la taqtulu anfusakum inna allaha kana bikum rahim. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses the believers in an ayah that's filled with so many lessons, especially from a fiqh perspective, the perspective of Islamic jurisprudence. Allah addresses the believers, and in this address, He warns them against taking ownership of the wealth of other Muslim brothers and sisters without their consent and without their happiness in any way or form. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and do not kill yourselves, protect your lives, do not put your lives on the line, right? In grave danger, in harm's way, inna Allaha kana bikum rahima. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to you all, He is perpetually, perfectly merciful. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we see day in and day out how merciful the Sharia is, the laws of Islam are, and how these laws, no doubt, come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the especially merciful and the entirely merciful. Brothers and sisters in Islam, yesterday we took an ayah from Surah Al-Baqarah in relation to wealth and eating halal pure food and earning in a halal pure way, and we discussed this whole concept of whether wealth is obtained or ordained and whether wealth is a blessing or a curse. And today we continue this discussion in Surah An-Nisa in relation to wealth. But here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us of a way through which we can earn in a haram way and thus consume haram food, which is totally forbidden. Allah tells us that you will earn in a haram way if you in any way or form usurp the wealth of others without right, without their consent and happiness. For example, lying about the cost price. If the other party knew the true cost price, they wouldn't have been happy, for example, to give over their money. For example, selling a product and lying about the capabilities of the product just to ensure that the deal goes through, right? Making promises that you can't fulfill. Maybe it's a promise to in relation to the warranty of the product that you're selling, and you cannot fulfill that promise. All this is haram, brothers and sisters in Islam. And all this constitutes you, and in the case of the sale going through, it constitutes you consuming the wealth of your fellow Muslim brother or sister without right, without their consent. Because had they known, they would have refused. They wouldn't have handed over their money, their wealth, happily. And Ikrimah, he has a report that goes back to Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, in which Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma explains the reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this particular ayah. And he mentions that at the time, people used to have a type of deal whereby they would sell something, for example, a thawb, and they would say, if you like the thawb, take it. And if you don't like it, you can return it, but you must also return a portion of some money along with your return. Subhanallah. That I'll give you back your money, what you paid, but I'm going to keep some. Right? For whatever reason, you're returning the thawb, the condition is you return it and you pay something with it. Right? Either you pay or I'll take it from the amount that you paid for the thawb initially. Now, brothers and sisters in Islam, on what grounds can a person do this? Right? Because if I buy a thawb and now I'm not happy with the thawb, of course I have a right to return it. Because I gave my money, right? And I'm not happy now with the money that I spent or with the concept of this purchase. I want my money back because I'm not happy with the thawb. I'll only be happy with what I gave if I'm happy with what I bought. So how can now the seller tell me return the thawb and also pay for the return? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayah, making sure that this practice ceases. And all practice that people can think of that are similar cease as well. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is amazingly clear and eloquent, and the Quran is amazingly clear and eloquent. Now, brothers and sisters in Islam, the last part of the ayah, Allah in the last part of the ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do not kill yourself, subhanallah. But pay attention to this. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man mata duna malihi fahuwa shaheed. Whoever dies defending his or her wealth, Allah will give them the status of shahada. Subhanallah. Allah doesn't want you to put your life in grave danger. But if someone is stealing your money, and you defending your money means you defending it with yourself, and in the process you pass away, subhanallah, Allah gives you the status of shahada. And the scholars of Islam have deduced from this hadith that if someone is stealing your wealth and you defend your wealth, and in the process they are severely harmed or they even pass away, then you are absolved of any blame or any harm, on condition, of course, that you can prove that you were defending your wealth in the process of this person having died. Understand, brothers and sisters in Islam, from this, how sacred wealth is in Islam, subhanAllah. How sacred wealth is in Islam. And if we're fundraising this Ramadan, be clear also, brothers and sisters in Islam, in terms of the message you put out there. Don't fundraise in a way doing gymnastics with your words where people think that we're giving our money over because so-and-so is going to do this with the money or that with the money, and you have other intentions, or you haven't been absolutely honest and true in terms of your messaging that convinced people to give you their money. Some people say, you know, they give the impression that it's 100% donor policy, but it's not 100% donor policy. And this is important to the person who's handing over their money, that it must be 100% donor policy. And obviously this is not a sale-based transaction, but it applies as well, because Allah says, do not you take other people's wealth, do not take the believer's wealth without their consent and without their happiness. Had they known that you were doing gymnastics with your words, no doubt they wouldn't have given you their money, they would have looked for another organization to hand over their donation to. So brothers and sisters in Islam, take special care. Right? Take special care. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all. Until another moment, salamullahi alaykum wa rahmatuhu wa barakatuhu.